tonight after a day of debating refugee resettlement. St. Louis County board members decide to wait for a federal ruling on the issue. Plus, just trying to get by. That's the message from mining-related companies as they see their bottom line take a hit while the iron ore industry struggles to survive the COVID-19 pandemic. And riots take over Minneapolis. Thousands flock to the streets protesting a deadly altercation between police and an unarmed black man.
From CBS 3 Duluth, this is the CBS 3 News at 10.
Good evening. I'm Kristen Bakke. Thanks for joining us. We're starting tonight with meteorologist Dave Anderson because there is at least the threat of our first severe summer weather moving over the region. Dave, you've been tracking it all night for us tonight. What's the latest?
Well, you put it pretty well there, Kristen. It's a threat of severe weather, and it's been close to the threshold to be called severe weather, but bubbling just under. But whether it's 1 degree over, 1 degree under, it's still a potentially dangerous situation. So let's look at the latest here. Eyeing up Minnesota and Wisconsin, we still have a low-pressure system working through with a cold front kicking up showers and especially thunderstorms in northwestern Wisconsin. Those are the storms that have been rumbling, since about 5:30 here tonight. Haven't quite become severe, no, but they've been dumping plenty of rain. And I'll show you the latest rain totals in a little bit, along with how much more could come by tomorrow morning. Well, we take a look now at what we're facing. Well, I guess I'm telling you right now how much rain we've received so far. I lose track of myself sometimes. Half inch in Solon Springs, 1.31 inches in Hayward already. A half inch for International Falls, lesser amounts for folks in between. Dense fog advisory for Lake Superior overnight. And because of this heavy rain, flash flood watch stays in effect through Wednesday morning. If it fires up and turns into a warning, I'll let you know. Hopefully within the time allotted, it goes away. What am I saying? I want this to come. No, we want it to go away, but get the rain we need. And we'll talk more about both counts coming up in a little bit.
Thanks, Dave. The St. Louis County Board once again delayed voting on whether to allow refugees to settle in the county. The board heard comment from more than 90 people over a period of 10 hours. In the end, they decided by a vote of 4-3 to send the matter back to the county administration. The Trump administration signed an executive order requiring counties to vote whether to accept refugees within their borders. A judge halted the order pending litigation, which also removes the deadline for the county to decide. The board voted to again wait to decide pending the outcome of that litigation. The deadline was set for June 1st. Only one refugee has settled in St. Louis County in the last 9 years. Duluth Mayor Emily Larson took to Facebook to share her disappointment with the county board. She says their decision not to vote was just an effort to avoid the issue altogether. She added it's out of alignment with the values of Minnesotans claim to hold, saying it's wrong to turn away people fleeing for their lives, saying refugees are welcome in Duluth. Meanwhile, the Duluth City Council is also making some tough decisions regarding the future of Spirit Mountain and the Duluth Lake Walk. We'll have much more on that later on in the show. Tonight, four Minneapolis police officers have been fired, and the FBI is investigating after a black man died following a confrontation with police. It comes after cell phone video showed one of the officers with his knee on George Lloyd's neck for at least 7 minutes. Even after Floyd's body went limp and well after he told the officer he could not breathe. He was unarmed at the time and police were responding to a forgery call at a nearby deli. Officers say he was resisting arrest. Both the police chief and the city's mayor weighed in on the incident.
Public trust continues and it must be the cornerstone of how the Minneapolis Police Department is going to build that trust and change our culture.
Being black in America should not be a death sentence. When you hear someone calling for help, you are supposed to help.
Valuing black lives.
The police officers were wearing body cameras. That footage has not been released yet. And tonight, protesters gathered outside of the restaurant where it happened. Protesters began marching from Chicago Avenue to the Minneapolis Police Department's 3rd Precinct building, 2 miles northeast, early Tuesday evening. Police started making a barrier around the precinct at about 7:30. PM as protesters began to swarm. Video shows some protesters sitting on the ground while officers deployed smoke bombs or tear gas and flash grenades. Some protesters smashed windows, threw bricks and rocks. U.S. Senator Amy Klobuchar was in Duluth today highlighting the need for more funding to help domestic violence survivors. Klobuchar, who represents Minnesota, says since the coronavirus pandemic started, the number of calls for help have increased statewide. With people stuck together in their homes, it's more challenging for survivors to reach out. She says the CARES Act provided $670,000 in domestic violence response funding to Minnesota alone, but more needs to be done to shine a light on this hidden crime.
A lot of times these crimes that occur behind closed doors just keep getting worse. And the fact that the shelter is so prominent right here near the courthouse is really, really important.
Klobuchar says the HEROES Act, which recently passed the U.S. House, would provide another $100 million in domestic violence funding. She says the Senate plans to take it up next week. Four mines in 4 weeks. Between layoffs and shutdowns, the Minnesota iron mining industry has been hit hard by the COVID-19 pandemic. With nearly 2,000 miners out of work, the economic hit to communities has set in. In this special edition of Eye on Mining, we're exploring how a downturn in the industry has a much broader impact to both the economy and to those who service and supply it.
Just down from Hibbing's Main Street sits Lind Industrial Supply, a family-owned business.
I know what he's going to do before he does it.
And I know where his phone and keys are.
Yeah. A father-son duo, Art and Roger Lind, have 75 years of combined experience in the mining industry.
We're a service company and a sales arm for manufacturers on the Iron Range. Our customer are all the major suppliers and producers of taconite.
From the concentrator to the crusher to the pellet plant, Lind Industrial Supply was built off mining.
Everything from mines up in the Upper Peninsula to North Shore Mining is a big customer of ours. Hibbing Taconite, United Taconite, Keetac, Mintac, and Minorca.
Making up about 99% of their business. So when things are good, the Linds thrive. But in a time like this, when the industry is suffering, their goal is to make sure the business they built can survive.
We're looking forward to a real good year, you know, and then something like this comes along.
On the Iron Range, that's the case for many mining-related companies.
It drives the economy up here.
Mark Phillips is commissioner of the Iron Range Resources and Rehabilitation Board. He says this downturn is different because there's no playbook for COVID-19.
In past mining recessions, we've had the opportunity, some businesses branch out and find other markets in other parts of the country and the world, and they adjust. Now the whole world is in this recession, so this is kind of unique.
State Senator Dave Tomasoni agrees.
I used to say that when the steel industry got a hiccup, the Iron Range would get the flu. And in this case, it's an actual virus.
The senator has served the Iron Range for nearly 30 years as an elected official.
Five of the six taconite mines are in my Senate district.
He's been through a number of boom and busts, but he says it never gets any easier.
The entire Iron Range suffers when the mining industry has a downturn.
According to a study done by UMD's Labovitz School, for every job in the iron ore mining industry, another two jobs are created. For example, if 1,000 miners are laid off, it's expected that another 2,000 jobs will be impacted, many of them coming from the vendor-supplier industry.
I'm hoping we can get back. I'm hoping the mining industry will rebound later this year, and we don't lose a lot of those businesses that are so important to our communities. So we're going to do everything we can to keep them open.
With Mintac, Minorca, and United Taconite still operating, the Linds are still supplying, and that's keeping their business afloat. But they are anticipating a big hit to their bottom dollar.
I would say at least a third of our income.
This year.
From the 80s to the 90s to the 2000s, Art has experienced a number of shutdowns during his more than 50 years in the industry. And he says he's learned from each and every one.
We don't have a big overhead operation here. And I don't have a high overhead operation at my house or anything like that. So we can get by.
But not every business will be able to. Commissioner Phillips says there's still a lot of work to be done.
We need help at all levels. So we need business help at the federal level, the state level, and then we're going to do it regionally and locally, work with our communities. Because if all of us don't pitch in, we don't have the resources to solve this problem.
For the Lind family, the Iron Range is their home. And no matter the obstacles, they plan to continue working with the industry that helped build their business.
It's not going to last forever. We'll get through it, and there'll be good days down the line.
Commissioner Phillips added that the IRRB will most likely be rolling out some new programs to help small businesses as they try to navigate the COVID-19 pandemic. The board has a meeting coming up in June. We'll be sure to update you on any new developments that come from that meeting right here on CBS3. Still to come, Spirit Mountain won't be opening at all this summer, adding another blow to an already troubling year financially for the recreation area. Their plea to the city council next.
Today's high temperature, 75 degrees. That heat helped fuel the storms we're seeing right now. It'll be even warmer tomorrow, but a lot calmer. Then after that, a cool down comes. So we'll talk about all these different flavors of weather coming our way, coming up in just a bit.
Memorial Day sale. Save up to 30% store-wide, plus get no interest financing until 2023. Shop in the store by appointment or online, plus free no-contact shipping during Home Furniture's Memorial Day sale.
Hello, Northland.
It's good to see you.
During this time, staying healthy might look a little bit different.
But we're still here. Take care for you.
St. Luke's now offers new ways for you to see us.
Like telehealth video visits, which is how I'm talking to you right now.
If you do need to be seen in person, you can rest assured.
We are keeping our clinics and hospitals clean and safe.
If you have any questions
or want to make an appointment,
give us a call.
We'll be happy to help.
Whether it's protecting your lawn or your pets, Fleet Farm has what you need. This week, save online and in stores on things like Frontline Plus flea and tick control. On sale starting at $34.99. Cashews, 1-pound bags are $5.99. Diamond Crystal Bright and Soft Pellets, 40-pound bags are $4.59. And Mix or Match annual flowers and vegetables, 48-count flats are $19.99. No matter the job, we've got you covered. Fleet Farm, built for real life.
Engines are restarting. Park is shifting to drive. So we're offering 0% financing for 72 months and no payments for 120 days. Plus the freedom to shop and buy online. Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram will help you drive forward.
Or now during the Memorial Day sales event, well-qualified returning lessees can lease the 2020 Jeep Renegade Latitude 4x4 for $200 a month.
Join our team at St. Anne's. St. Anne's residents is calling to service nursing assistants, LPNs, personal caregivers, and food service workers. We offer excellent pay, bonus opportunities, and great people to work with. Apply online. Together, we are St. Anne's strong.
You work hard for your money and deserve to see it go the extra mile. Join us Wednesday mornings and hear from local experts on tips to better manage your finances in Eye on Money on Live Local CBS 3. Brought to you by MPPL Financial.
During the Memorial Day sale at Home Sleep Express, get $150 to $500 in factory-authorized savings on Purple and Tempur-Pedic. Plus, no interest financing for 6 years, free delivery and setup. Memorial Mattress Savings at Home Sleep Express.
CBS 3 Weather is brought to you by Kerry Toyota. Now, the CBS 3 Duluth WeatherMax Forecast with meteorologist Dave Anderson.
We needed a good soaking rain, and a lot of towns have received that. Now let's hope we don't get so much that there are flooding problems. Indeed, a good portion of our region looking at a flash flood watch until early tomorrow morning, till about 7 o'clock. That includes the Twin Ports area, Carlton County, Pine County, and Minnesota, and most of the western portion of northwestern Wisconsin. It looks like Iron County's off the hook, and so is the Upper Peninsula. Along the shores of the lake, looking at a dense fog advisory till 1 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. So drive carefully along the shoreline, and of course, in this interior part of our region, drive carefully as well in case the ditches get overwhelmed. There's a chance they could. Some towns have received an inch of rain already and could get another inch here before 7 o'clock tomorrow morning. Current conditions in Duluth show a lot of fog, calm wind, 60 degrees for the current temp, and a relative humidity reading of 93%, hence the dense fog advisory close to the lake. Temperature-wise, what are we getting out here? Well, still a little bit on the warmer side for parts of Wisconsin and the Upper Peninsula with highs in the, or current temps in the upper 60s. Places like Superior or Park Point down to 50, Two Harbors 55, still low 60s towards inland parts of Minnesota. That's because a cold front in conjunction with a low is knocking our temperatures down as it converts moisture into rain. A little bit of rain cooling the atmosphere here in our region right now. And looking at that cold front starting to enter northwestern Wisconsin. And so that, for a couple more hours, may enhance the thunderstorms that are just bubbling under severe, but then put the kibosh on them as the colder, drier air behind the front comes in to settle things down. But it won't stay cold for long. No, we could be even warmer tomorrow than we were today. I'm thinking upper 70s to about 80 degrees. Now, how much rain are we going to get on top of what we've already received? Well, places like International Falls may be done, and maybe another tenth towards Hibbing as we get towards tomorrow morning. But another half to three quarters of an inch possible in the Twin Ports. Almost a half inch towards the Hayward region, and maybe even Ironwood will get about a half inch coming across there as well. So again, drive cautiously just in case your roadways are flooded, partially flooded. Hopefully that goes away quickly. And then we chase away the fire danger too, thanks to the rain. So in Minnesota tonight, still a 60% chance or more of that rain. Maybe a couple of thunderstorms embedded, low temps, 40s by the lake, upper 40s. So maybe mid to upper 50s farther inland. Wisconsin and Michigan, 80% chance you'll get more rain till about 7 o'clock tomorrow morning, maybe even a little longer towards the UP, lows 55 to 60. In Wisconsin, Michigan tomorrow, the high temps are pretty warm, 78 to 80, slowly clearing sky after we shake off that low pressure system. And Minnesota, 65 to 70 by the lake, 80 inland, slowly clearing sky. But the temperatures will spike high early and then fall off as higher pressure takes over. We chase away the clouds. And then the flow of that high starts to pull Canadian air into our region by Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. We drop into the 60s after a couple of days of pert near 80. Then, Kristen, next Monday and Tuesday, a fresh low pressure system could bring back the chance for showers and storms.
Thanks, Dave. Spirit Mountain is struggling to find a way forward that's profitable, thanks in large part to the pandemic. Officials with the ski mountain say it won't be reopening again until winter. Not opening this summer means losing hundreds of thousands of dollars from weddings, mountain biking, and the Hills Adventure Park. Tonight, the Duluth City Council approved the Spirit Mountain's $4 million annual budget. They did not vote to give any additional funds to Spirit Mountain. However, the budget presumes the council will have to invest in the business at some point moving forward.
We are looking at a total bottom line of a profit of $9,195. But again, we are going to have cash flow increases and decreases, and we are going to need the City of Duluth's support with this.
A Spirit Mountain Task Force will be formed this summer. It's expected to look at a variety of options to help ensure its long-term success. For more information, head to cbs3duluth.com. We'll hear more from Spirit Mountain leaders and city councilors tomorrow morning on our morning show. Also tonight, the council approved moving forward with the Canal Park Lakewalk project. The third and final phase of the reconstruction amounts to more than $10 million, most of which is paid for through state and federal funds, according to councilors. The lake walk had been damaged in years past by a series of heavy storms. Councilors say the lake walk is critical to the city's tourism industry. Still to come on Live Local CBS 3, evaluating students' learning from home. That's what Duluth school leaders are wrestling with as distance learning begins wrapping up for the year.
CBS 3 Live Cams are brought to you by Kohler Chevrolet Buick GMC Cadillac. You're not just getting a car, you're getting Kohler.
Family owned and operated since 1952, Grusendorf Nursery has the largest selection of fruit trees, flowering shrubs, evergreens, shade trees, berry plants, and more, along with assorted wood mulches, rock, and soil. Whether you're refreshing your existing landscape or starting from scratch, let the knowledge handed down from generation to generation on quality nursery stock and professionalism guide you, because we believe you deserve the very best.
Let the experience of three generations be your final answer on all your landscaping needs here at Grusendorf Nursery.
This is a fun game.
What are you doing?
Hey, it's your sister. Maybe she wants to help Daddy. Wow.
Should I get Mom?
Mama doesn't need to know. Mom doesn't need to know. Hey, Ron.
The new battery-powered 60-volt mower from Toro makes mowing simple, so you can enjoy more quality time with your family.
Lawn looks good, though.
At Denny's Lawn and Garden.
You're ready to drive again, and not just to the neighborhood store. In a new Honda, you can enjoy the open road with powerful performance. And your money can go farther, too, because Honda holds its value better than any other auto brand. Your Honda dealer is offering flexibility, like shopping online, so you can purchase with confidence. Get your new Honda today. KBB.com's 2020 Best Value Brand.
Work hard for your money and deserve to see it go the extra mile. Join us Wednesday mornings and hear from local experts on tips to better manage your finances in Eye on Money on Live Local CBS 3. Brought to you by MPPL Financial. Watch Anthony Mann weekdays at 6 and 10 p.m. on Live Local CBS 3 Duluth. On the go, but want to keep up with the day's news? Don't worry. Now we are wherever you are. Traveling? No problem. Stream wherever, whenever with Live Local CBS 3. Find your favorite CW shows on the Duluth CW, cable, satellite, over the air, and streaming on KDLH Duluth. Watch Anthony Mann weekdays at 6 and 10 p.m. on Live Local CBS 3 Duluth.
As the school year and distance learning starts to wind down, students' report cards will look slightly different than years past. Due to COVID-19, the Duluth Public School District, like many others across the state, has made changes to how they'll hand out grades. Parents we spoke with have mixed reviews. CBS3's Emma Quinn reports.
Justine Bickle has been helping her kids, Evie and Wesley, with remote learning for almost 2 months now. Usually, they attend Myers-Wilkins Elementary.
We decided to pick up the packets, which ended up working because they were able to do online communication with their teachers and their classmates.
But as distance learning comes to an end for students and summer vacation begins, their report cards for the fourth quarter will look different. A move Duluth School District Superintendent Bill Gronson says reflects some of the challenges faced during the pandemic.
It's recognizing the work that they're doing and providing feedback, but not making it a situation where this one quarter during a pandemic would negatively affect their future.
For example, Duluth high schoolers will be given a traditional A, B, C, or D letter grade, which would impact their GPAs. They won't get an F. Instead, students would receive no mark, meaning they didn't earn the credit and their GPA won't be impacted. But students have another option.
With this plan, if they would prefer to have a pass, no pass, or a no mark, as it were, that is an option.
Meanwhile, for elementary school students, there will also be two additional marks to report progress, IP for in progress and DL for distance learning. Both are set to mark standards that weren't fully assessed or taught due to distance learning. Sharon Redbrook has a hard time grasping the new grading system.
They're changing it, and it kind of confusing. Is really, really wordy.
Redbrook has kids at Ordine East Middle School and East High School. She worries distance learning could impact her children down the road, no matter what grade they earned.
How do you guide our children for their academic future? I don't want to make a decision that's going to impact them down the road.
This grading system will not reflect the grades of students in college in the classroom classes, as those grades are given out by the universities the school partners with. Coming up in sports, hear what Minnesota Wild GM Bill Guerin has to say following the announcement that hockey is returning.
Eye on Mining is brought to you by Iron Mining Association and Range Regional Airport.
Imagine building your Range Regional Airport without the mining industry. Now, imagine air travel without mining. We couldn't imagine that either. Welcome to Range Regional Airport, serving and supporting the Iron Range.
Northwest Outlet Store is open.
Yes,
Northwest Outlet is open for business. Tuesday through Saturday, 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Now, get up to 40% off of the North Face and Columbia's entire line of summer clothing. New colors, styles on capris, tees, shorts, rain, wind, and fleece jackets. And UPF sun-rated clothing. Big bargains on sandals, rubber boots, and trail shoes from Keen, Teva, Merrill, Chaco, Columbia, and the North Face. Northwest Outlet is open Tuesdays through Saturdays, 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. And online 24-7 with curbside pickups during store hours.
For 50 years, family-owned Crenson has proudly been serving the Twin Ports and surrounding communities. We make the vehicle buying process simple, straightforward, and stress-free. Drive away in a 2020 Honda CR-V today with 1.9% financing for 60 months or 2.9% financing for 72 months. We're open. Stop in any time or, if you prefer, call for a no-contact appointment for sales or service. Visit us online for our complete inventory listing. Crenson, two locations, one great team.
We want to say thank you.
Thank you.
To the first responders.
Thank you.
To the truck drivers.
And delivery people.
Thank you.
Thank you. To the doctors.
The nurses. And all the hospital workers.
The grocery store workers.
The janitors.
And sanitation workers.
Show them kindness, patience, and gratitude.
They are the real heroes.
Thank you for all of your bravery and hard work.
Thank you all.
We all want to do our part to keep our communities safe.
Thank you for your efforts to stay home, but you shouldn't stay home no matter what.
If you have a medical emergency, call 911 immediately. Our emergency departments are open and ready to care for every type of illness or injury.
If you have a chronic condition, call your clinic and we can help manage your care. Our facilities are clean and safe.
Please, seek care when you need it.
Essentia Health and St. Luke's are open and ready to care for you.
Powerful change occurs when people unite. We unite people to activate positive change, to make lives better. Help us fight for what's right for all: basic needs, access to health care, a good education, and financial stability. There's strength in numbers. Join us and live united. HLUnitedWay.org.
Imagine building your Range Regional Airport without the mining industry. Now, imagine air travel without mining. We couldn't imagine that either. Welcome to Range Regional Airport, serving and supporting the Iron Range.
Of the three major sports leagues currently suspended in the United States, the NHL has emerged as the first to put in a plan. As of about 3:31 Central Standard Time today, we have a plan for hockey to return to our television screens. Commissioner Gary Bettman held a press conference this afternoon laying out all the details in an agreement signed off on by both the league and the Players Association. They have deemed the regular season to be officially complete. They'll begin an expanded playoff format of 24 teams, 12 from each conference. The Eastern Conference will play out the playoffs in one hub city, the West in another hub city. No dates have been released yet, but rather a four-phase plan outlining how things need to happen in order to get hockey back. Here it is. Phase one and two focus on getting players back to training set tentatively, if all goes according to plan, in the beginning of June. Phase three will see the start of team training camps no earlier than the first half of July. And phase four, allowing that, we'll see the 24-team playoffs with seeding games and play-in rounds. Those playoff games will take place in those two hub cities, still to be determined. At this time, this is the list they have narrowed it down to. You'll notice Minneapolis and St. Paul still in the running.
Health and safety is the most important thing, so there must be tests available for us on a wide-scale basis without disrupting any medical needs. And there are governmental issues. For example, currently we don't think we could do this in the Canadian markets because there's a 14-day quarantine We are talking to the Canadian government about it. But if we get done with training camp and we want to go to a Canadian city, and to do that, we have to quarantine for another 14 days, that isn't going to work. So we're going to have to take our time. We're probably 3 weeks or more away from having to make a decision.
While General Manager Bill Guerin spoke to the media in a conference call today following the announcement.
I think we all understand how unique this year is and, you know, how crazy it's been. And we've just got to roll with it a little bit. So, you know, I'm excited about it. It'll be different. It'll be new. And the Minnesota Wild are involved in it. So there's really not much to be upset about or negative about.
The Minnesota Wild are involved in it. Should the NHL get the go-ahead from state and local officials, the Wild, who finished 35-27 in the regular season, will have a spot in that 2014 playoffs. Ideally, the Wild will play Vancouver in a first-round best-of-five qualifying playoff series. The playoff format allows for the top four seeds in each conference to get byes in the first round. Seeds 5 through 12 get the first-round best-of-five series. And finally, a check-in with the state of Grandma's virtual marathon with actual race day just under 4 weeks away. Some runners continue to run their race early. Registration was reopened for a brief period, but is now officially closed. 577 new runners registered during that window. In the new virtual format, runners can submit their times from May 4th through July 31st. That goes for the full marathon, the Gary Bjorklund Half Marathon, and the William A. Irvin 5K. So here's a look at how things sit right now. Just about 6% of the runners have finished the full and half marathons, nearly a 2% increase from last week. Grandma's Marathon officials still expect most runners to be out on the original race day, Saturday, June 20th. That's going to do it for sports tonight. We'll be right back after the break.
CBS 3 closed captioning is brought to you by Essentia Health Skin Renewal Center, reminding you to apply sunscreen 15 minutes before heading out for fun in the sun.
As we work to get through these challenging times, we're working on your new home. View at Bluestone offers pet-friendly, modern living that meets all of your needs. Learn more, take a virtual tour, and lease online at view@bluestone.com.
Mariah Haberman here from Discover Wisconsin. Join me and the rest of the DW crew every week on this station for all things Wisconsin. Continue the adventure on social media and discoverwisconsin.com for behind-the-scenes content and great Wisconsin giveaways, including a chance to win a free vacation. This week's featured prize package could take you to the Hayward Lakes area. Just visit discoverwisconsin.com for details.
Purdy Lawn Service, offering mowing, fertilizing, aerating, landscaping, and snow removal in the Duluth Superior area. Call 218-341-9860 for free estimates and visit us on Facebook. Purdy Lawn Service, unbeatable quality and service, now hiring seasonal and full-time employees.
DBS, your all things basement-y company. Does your home have uneven or sloping floors? How about cracked drywall, stair-stepping cracks, or bowed basement walls? You may have a problem with your foundation. Call the specialists at DBS. They thoroughly inspect your property and provide a permanent solution to your foundation problem. We offer a fully transferable warranty, unmatched in our area. Contact DBS, your all things basement-y company, for a free, no-obligation estimate. Call or visit us online. DBS, helping your family have a healthy, safe, and comfortable home.
Dude, you gonna pick that up? Because there's no poop fairy to do that for you. See? Take these. They're not just poop bags. They're pride bags. Because you're doing the right thing for your neighbors and for the health of the whole watershed. Got a fly? There's a chihuahua cranking one out in Leicester right now. There is no poop fairy.
View at Bluestone, Duluth's newest multi-generational living, just up the hill, is coming soon. We are leasing studio, one and two bedrooms for August 2021. Take a virtual apartment tour or lease virtually from anywhere. Your new view awaits. View at Bluestone.com.
Find your favorite CW shows on the Duluth CW, cable, satellite, over the air, and streaming on KDLH Duluth.
right, Dave, let's get a final look at the weather here before we go.
All right, we'll take one last look at the radar, which shows a cold front and a low pressure system still plowing across our region, taking its sweet time, especially delivering heavier rains in northwest Wisconsin. May continue to do so through early tomorrow morning, about 7 o'clock in the morning. That's the duration of a flash flood watch covering the eastern parts of Minnesota and the western parts of Wisconsin. Also in conjunction with that, we have a dense fog advisory for shoreline communities around Lake Superior. So temperature-wise, we hit 75 today. Might be warmer tomorrow.
Thanks for joining us. We'll see you tomorrow.